The heat from this mass and its poisonous smell were both so unbearable that even birds hesitated to fly over the gully but circled around it. All living things kept away from the mountain. Now, Guph had heard, during his long lifetime, many tales of these dreaded phantasms, so he had heard of this barrier of melted lava, and also he had been told that there was a narrow bridge that spanned it in one place. So he walked along the edge until he found the bridge. It was a single arch of gray stone, and lying flat upon the bridge was a scarlet alligator, seemingly fast asleep. When Guph stumbled over the rocks in approaching the bridge, the creature opened its eyes, from which tiny flames shot in all directions, and after looking at the intruder very wickedly, the scarlet alligator closed its eyelids again and lay still. Guph saw there was no room for him to pass the alligator on the narrow bridge, so he called out to it, "Good morning, friend. I don't wish to hurry you, but please tell me if you were coming down or going up." "Neither," snapped the alligator, clicking its cruel jaws together. The general hesitated. "Are you likely to stay there long?" he asked. "A few hundred years or so," said the alligator. Guph softly rubbed the end of his nose and tried to think what to do. "Do you know whether the first and foremost phantasm of Fantastico is at home or not?" he presently inquired. "I expect he is, seeing he is always at home," replied the alligator. "Ah, who is that coming down the mountain?" asked the gnome, gazing upward. The alligator turned to look over its shoulder, and at once Guph ran to the bridge and leaped over the sentinel's back before it could turn back again.